It is with pride that we present our country, Sri Lanka, the pearl of the Indian Ocean. Sri Lanka is an island rich with natural beauty, and we encounter multiple diversities along its coastlines, valley areas, and the hill country. The numerous varieties of plants and animals, some even indigenous to our country, can be found with its pleasing beauty. The longest river in Sri Lanka, the Mahaveli, runs through all geographical regions, starting from the hill country, flowing downwards and across the country to the Indian Ocean. Sigiriya, which marks the enrichment of our historical culture, has been recognized as a World Heritage Site. The beauty of the island is highlighted also by its multi-ethnic culture. There are Sinhalese, Tamils, Moors, and Burghers, all interacting in one social network. This contributes to the unity and the hospitality that prevails in the society, even though there may be various cultural and religious practices. In the same area, one may encounter a Christian church, a Buddhist temple, a mosque, and a kovil, all observing their rituals and practices. The Portuguese spread Roman Catholicism, and the Dutch, who took over the country, introduced the Dutch Reformed Church. But the British, who came in 1796, took over the country and influenced each and every aspect of it. They played a main role in religion as well, and many natives were given the opportunity to explore the aspects of the Church of England. Later on, there were many denominations that emerged, such as the Methodist and the Baptist churches. This spread of Christianity resulted in the rising importance of the Word of God among the Sri Lankan society. The need to produce Bibles to benefit the community and draw them closer to God was prevailing at that time when the Ceylon Bible Society was founded on the 1st of August 1812 as an auxiliary of the British and foreign Bible societies. The main objective of the Bible Society is to cater to the need of the community so that it could motivate the Sri Lankan community to grow in their faith. With the support of a devoted staff, we are able to conduct many activities in order to fulfill this objective on a large scale. By widening our goals with each step, the most prominent activities are Bible translations, organizing programs with the denominational churches, Bible distribution island-wide, especially free among those who have economical barriers to afford a Bible. A very successful step in this field was the distribution of Bibles in the camps for the internally displaced persons, where it was a great motivational factor to those deprived and hapless war victims who are finally able to reach greener pastures after the end of the 30-year-old war. The specialization of the production of Bibles has reached every aspect of the society, especially for the specially abled, where we produce user-friendly Bibles and other scripture-based material in Braille language. In order to improve these activities, we have located several centers all around the country. These not only provide assistance to our main goals, but also serve the community through allowing them to make use of our resources to conduct seminars and other important activities that help the enrichment of the lives of our citizens. The church population is 1.5 million in a country with a 20 million population. We produce over 50,000 Bibles per annum in order to cater proactively to the needs of the community and also to reach those who have not yet heard the Word of God. By the oncoming 200th anniversary of the Ceylon Bible Society, we aim to distribute 10,000 Bibles so that all citizens of the country will have access to the Bible on request. The successful path taken by our society in this multi-ethnic and multi-religious country is constantly appreciated by many denominational leaders. The Ceylon Bible Society strives to contribute to the betterment of society through these numerous modes of community work, so that this beautiful island will be enriched not only with natural beauty, but also with God's grace, where His believers build a nation of peace and harmony.